everyone, my name is Alpha. Welcome to Plami Sims and welcome to another Speed Build. I hope you're all doing well and having such a fantastic day. So today we are building in the world of Willow Creek, and this is the first time I'm playing around with the season. So this is the first winter theme build I will be doing for a few weeks, I think, up until the end of December, maybe, I don't know. But I am doing a collab build today. So this collab was hosted by Paradise Plumbob. I will put everything in the description box below, but I found out about this collab on Discord server. So I'm not sure which server was it, but I think the stream chat. I could be totally wrong about that, but this has been a while back ago, and one of them named Emily May, or her ID is It's Emily May. She messaged me on Discord and she explained everything to me about the rules and the collab and everything. So we are doing a Christmas save collab, and I'm not sure when this will be posted because I record this on, what date is it? It's like 14th of November or something like that. So I record this on the weekend when the Blooming Rooms kit was released. But since it's a build for a collab, I tend to do it a bit earlier because I don't know, there's something about collab build that I have to prepare much sooner. So she actually wanted me to do a build with the like brick build for a family, for like a wealthy family, something like that. So the only slots left were this one over here, and the other one is like a Willow Creek style starter home, if that makes sense. So the shotgun style, something like that, and the other one is a budget house. And since I know I'm not good with budget house, I mean, I have a Strangerville budget home or something like that that I posted a few weeks ago, or maybe last week, but I know with budget I can't do much, because for me, in order to make everything looks lively, I have to put a ton of clutter, and clutter is very expensive. I mean, some clutters are even more expensive than a window, so that's just how expensive clutter is. So I decided just to do like a brick home with for a wealthy family. That's basically the proof that I was given, and I think I've only built in winter like once or twice maybe, and it's years ago, and I didn't know, at least up until I started on this save file, I didn't know that the lighting on this lot is terrible. So this is the Ophelia Villa lot. So this is lot where the God's family house is, and I have to say that the lighting is so strange. I tried several different times and with a few different settings. I mean, like maybe it'll be better on this time. I mean, the backyard is fine. You have no idea, the backyard lighting is so great, but the front is so dark and it's shadowy, and I couldn't figure out the perfect setting to make it look brighter. I don't know. I mean, I don't know, maybe it's just because it's winter, but I could be wrong. I don't know. I've never built on this lot before. I guess I could be wrong about that, but the lighting is incredibly strange. So I built it backwards. So the front is on the back and the back is on the front, if that makes sense. But later on I will rotate them so it'll be as it should be. So anyway, I think I've done something like this before. I mean, my first build using the Cottage Living expansion pack, I'm not sure what I call that, like Cottage something. I can link it in the description box below in case you want to check that out, as well as on the iCard. But I've built several different builds that looks like this. I mean, the shape of the exterior, because I think this kind of build is very common. It's not common here. I mean, the traditional like main structure is traditional, and you have this extension of a modern style, like a little bit more modern than the main building. And since this is for a family house, I decided just to do a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom situation here. But since I built this on platform, the lighting and the shadow is very intense. You have no idea how stressful I was when I was like doing the floor plan over here. I cut a lot of parts out because I had to deal with the crazy shadow on the upstairs. I'm not sure why it always happens like that. I have a ton of bales, like literally a ton of bales with platforms. I think I tend to use platforms over foundations now because you can like mix the heights of the wall, but it's so shadowy and the shadow is like crazy harsh. I have to put a, like, I don't know, 2-3 lights in the same spot just to make the harsh shadow like a little bit less visible, if that makes sense. And that's very annoying because when I take the screenshot, it'll make the room incredibly bright, and I don't know how to fix that. So if you know a way on how to fix it, please let me know. I tried a lot of things. I Google like a bunch of times, but it just doesn't help. I mean, I tried a lot of things to fix that, but it won't fix. So anyway, since this build is for a like Christmas team belt, I decided to put a Christmas tree, even though I will change the Christmas tree off camera when I play tested this build with the like regular Christmas tree from Seasons, because the one that I put on this build was from Holiday Free Pack, something like that, and it's actually a lamp. It's not like a real Christmas tree, if that makes sense. So I changed that off camera and I put a bunch of presents and also the decoration thing with the Christmas tree, and I tried to decorate the exterior of the house, but it's super glitchy. And once I place the decoration on or put the decoration, in a few hours, I mean Sims time, they're disappeared. I don't understand why it just happens like that. So at the end, I just put everything as fast as I could. I didn't even really notice which decoration that I've put, because yeah, it's disappeared in seconds. So if I did something terribly weird, I apologize in advance. But anyway, since this is such a very boxy house, I decided just to split the floor plan into like a closed off floor plan, if that makes sense. So the first story, or the downstairs over here, we have the kitchen, dining, a bathroom, and a living room. And for the upstairs, we have 3 bedrooms, so the master bedroom, and also we have 2 kids' bedrooms, and a kind of Jack and Jill situation bathroom. And also the landing area will be like the office space. Like, it's not like an office, but it's more like a desk and a computer and a not library, what is that, bookcase. So it's, I mean, it's classic traditional house in The Sims, and I've seen a lot of people build something like this. So yeah, I took some reference from them. But to be honest, I think this build is one of the longest build I've done. I mean, the only reason why it took me very long to finish this build was the floor plan, since I had to deal with the floor plan. I mean, I have almost an hour of footage of me placing the staircase and also doing the floor plan. I tried that like 3 different times, so this took very long to do the floor plan. But at the end, I really really like the floor plan. And we have 2 different arches on the living space. So one is for the kitchen, and the other one is for the kind of like a backyard entrance and for the bathroom. So you have like 2 different ways to access the kitchen. But we are now on the second story here, and this is the office that I've mentioned. And it's just a typical office with a desk, a computer, and a bookcase. And I think I didn't put any other computer on this build. I could be wrong about that. But I did put 2 different chimneys. So at first, I really, really wanted to do a fireplace like in line with the chimneys. But that's really hard if you do it in The Sims. In real life, it will be much easier, I would say. I mean, it's not common to have chimneys and fireplaces here because it's crazy hot here and we have no autumn, springs, and winter. We only have wet season, like raining, downpouring rain season, and also the like blazing hot summer-ish season and very humid weather 24/7. So yeah, fireplace isn't necessary here, but since I know it's more realistic to have like a fireplace in line with the chimneys, I tried to do that, but it's just impossible with the floor plan. So I decided just to do two fireplaces. I mean, we have two chimneys, so we have to have two fireplaces. So the first fireplace is on the living area downstairs, and we have the other fireplace here on the master bedroom. So it's a bit fancy. I mean, the kids' bedroom, they don't have fireplace. It's not that fancy, and I imagine that the kids are, they're not twins, but they're very close age-wise, so maybe they're just a few days apart, I would say. I mean, that's very possible in The Sims. In real life, pretty much no. But anyway, we are on the kids' bedroom, so I decided just to do very different kids' bedroom. So the first one is a very neutral, like gender neutral type of bedroom. It's blue, but pale blue, so it's kind of for daughters and sons, so it's totally fine. But the second one is for the daughter, and I've been wanting to build using that bed from Seasons with the cute curtains on it. It's super cute, and it's in purple, and since I love purple family tones, like lilac, purple, lavender, something like that, I am obsessed with that bedroom so much. And we are finally on the master bedroom here, and since I really want to use that cupboard from base game, the only problem is it's way too small. I mean, it's 2 tiles wide, but it's more like a 1¾ tiles wide, so I had to size it up like 1.5 times, I think. I could be wrong about that. Just in order to make it looks perfectly fit on that nook over there. So we are just finished with the bedroom, and we are now on the bathroom. So this is the Jack and Jill, kind of Jack and Jill bathroom, and we have 2 different access from the landing area and also the master bedroom or the parents' bedroom. So the kids can use this bathroom as well as the parents. And I have one question though. Since this is a winter build and everything is covered with snow, is it necessary though to put terrain paints? Because I was kind of on the fence on whether I should put the terrain paints or not, because I can't see it at all, like at all. But I can imagine if someone download this build and put it on their game, and their game is not in season, I mean, in not in winter time, it will be very strange to not have any terrain paints. So I tried to put that, even though I'm not sure is it look okay or it's just very harsh. I'm not sure, but I apologize in advance if everything looks kind of weird, because this is like snowing everywhere and I couldn't see anything besides the snow. So I am, to be honest, I'm not really sure about my landscaping on this build, but everything looks just very magical because everything is white. And since it's in winter, I decided just to put a hot tub from base game. I'm glad we have hot tub in base game, because I wanted to do a pool, but it's silly to swim when it's snowing outside, so I'd rather put a hot tub because it's like it makes your Sims a bit warmer and cozier and more relaxed, I think. So yeah, that's basically the backyard. So we just have to put on the plants and the landscaping on the front part of the house. And I am incredibly sorry if everything looks so strange. I mean, the terrain paints and the landscaping, I couldn't see at all, like everything's just white. I should have done with this build first and place it on my like regular season, I mean summer save file before I put this on the gallery. Yeah, anyway, we are just finishing up with the terrain paints, which is a very invisible terrain paints, and it's kind of useless now, but it won't be useless at all if it's in summer or spring or autumn. But anyway, we are just basically finishing up the build and we'll be heading on to the screenshot in just a second. So if you want to download this build, this has been up on the Sims 4 gallery. You could find it under my EA ID, which is Salvatierra, or under the hashtag FlyMeSims. You could also click the link in the description box below that will bring you to my Ko-fi website. It'll have two different links. The first one is the direct link to download it from the gallery, and the second one is the tray files download link. And I'll put every single participant and the download link for the save file in the description box below once it's available. So yeah, I think that is it. I really hope you did enjoy this video, and if you do, please make sure to hit the thumbs up button. Also, make sure to be subscribed to the channel if you haven't already. And if you'd like to, you could also ring the bell so you'll be notified every single time I upload a new video. So yeah, I'm going to sign off right now. Thank you so very much for joining me today and supporting my channel. Enjoy the rest of the screenshots, and I'll see you in the next video.